Well, everybody, it's Gersh Cousin, award-winning editor of the Brooklyn Paper, and I'm joined, of course, by Andy Campbell. He's our senior reporter, folks, and this is his last day, but I thought it'd be interesting, you know, I wanted to bring you into an actual editing session with Andy, because he's a great reporter, we're big fans, but he's also one of the most frustrating reporters I've ever worked with. So I'm going to bring up one of his stories on my screen right now. This is a new one. All right, let me just read it. What kind of lead is that? Are you kidding me?
Sorry, you tried.
You try a little harder next time. Okay, let's look at this.
I don't have your voice.
The city approved their plans? The city approves its plans. Subject-object agreement is the thing that separates us from dogs and other inarticulate beings like Flax.
I'm going to make it at the Post now.
You are a disaster. Let me look a little further into this story. But that contradicts. You got $318 million in the lead, and then you got $435 million. But what's the extra $1.5 billion? I don't know what you're doing. All right, I'm just going to send this story back to you. See, this is what I'm talking about. It's the kind of thing, but you know what? He's been like a son to me. And when I say he's been like a son to me, I mean like my 3-year-old son, who I love. I mean, I literally love that kid to death, but on occasion, he's very tiring. But Andy, you're one of the great senior reporters we ever had. Do me a favor. Give the viewer a little chance. What were some of your favorite stories?
I had a lot of great stories. I mean,
really?
I got laid one time. Had a column where I got laid.
Really?
Yeah.
Did I approve that column?
Yeah, you approved
it. Did I approve the expenses on that?
You also approved me getting my penis shaped into an exact replica dildo.
But that was your penis?
Yeah.
We have no first-hand information on that.
Mm-hmm.
And what else?
There was that time, I mean, just recently I got drunk at Freddy's, I believe that...
You really worked hard for us, huh?
Yeah, I worked really hard.
All right, well, let's go out into the newsroom and see how this, how your departure went down.
Andy, we're very sorry you're leaving. This is Brooklyn Logger. I know you're not going to be at the Brooklyn Paper anymore, but I want you to know that this is a very crisp, enjoyable lager. And it is delicious.
And now it's time for the ceremonial transfer of the senior reporter bowl from Andy Campbell to Natalie O'Neill. Let's see that go down.
Natalie, this is the senior reporter bowl. It's handed down to me from senior reporter Stephen Brown, who had it handed down to him from senior reporter Mike McLaughlin. I'm now bequeathing it to you as a talisman of my legacy. Hopefully you will be as legendary as I was in my year at the Brooklyn Paper.
Oh, thank you, sir.
Miss O'Neill, I wonder if we could ask you a quick question. Is there anything you actually learned from Andy in the 3 weeks you were working so closely with him?
Yeah, I learned that Andy Campbell protects his sources by using a condom.
Well, that's good advice really for any reporter. Am I right, Andy?
No, that's great. It's great.
So look, Andy, last thoughts? Any last thoughts at all? Because I got to say, I miss you. I'm going to miss you. But I'm also not going to miss you.
Well, you know, listen, I want to admit something to our readers. I came from the West Coast.
Yeah, well, that's
obvious. Most
people
don't think that because I've been such a great East Coast reporter. But I will say, this paper molded me into a hard-hitting journalist.
Yeah. When I met Andy Campbell, he was lazy.
I was lazy.
Yeah.
And now I'm just lazy and a little bit hungover.
Really? Okay, well, great. Anyway, we're going to leave you with a standard musical tribute to the work of Andy Campbell, one of the greats, everybody. And I'm Gersh Cousman, award-winning editor, who molds these pieces of clay into hard-hitting reporters.
Love you guys.
Good morning, yesterday. You wake up and time has slipped away. And suddenly it's hard to find the memories you left behind.